If you're looking for total protection against blow-by getting rerouted back into your 2015 and 16 3.5 EcoBoost motor, then Mishimoto's baffled catch can setup here will be for you. Now, the Mishi setup is going to offer two separate catch cans, one for your PCV and one for your CCV, which is very unique in the category. Price point for the dual setup here will be right around $400, and the install will get a middle-of-the-road 2 out of 3 wrenches on the difficulty meter. Take you a couple of hours to complete from start to finish, as we'll show you guys here in a little bit. Now, if you didn't know the benefits of a catch can or oil separator by now, you should definitely get up to speed on why they exist and why you should have one on your rig. And a great way to do so is to check out my What's Up With That video, all things oil separators here on the channel. But let's get into the Mishimoto dual can setup because it is certainly unique compared to some of your other options currently in the category. First and foremost, you're getting not one, but two separate catch cans that tap into two separate systems. The PCV, which is your positive crankcase ventilation, and your CCV, which is your crankcase ventilation. Now, essentially, they both serve roughly the same purpose, but the CCV is actually metered air, so therefore a sensor is involved. Now, most aftermarket catch can or oil separator setups are only gonna capture the blow-by present in the PCV system, but again, Mishi is one of the few to capture both, so you have a very aggressive approach to capturing blow-by from all angles. Now, aside from that, the Mishi is also gonna pack some of the biggest or largest capacity in the category, with a 12-ounce canister on this end here, that's the big boy, and then a 3-ounce canister on this side, which is typically what you see with most aftermarket separators by itself. So working together, you have essentially longer service intervals, basically less time checking and emptying the cans. Now, these two cans have been built using very high quality 6061 anodized black billet aluminum, do include things like internal baffles and also a check valve to help prevent any pressurization of the cans itself. Now, the internal aluminum filter is good for capturing particles roughly 40 microns in size before dropping into one of the two included cans. Now, the cans themselves do mount using the 3mm thick steel bracket here, which has been finished off in a black powder coat. Finally, Mishimoto does include all of the half-inch hose, as you can see right here, has been cut to length already, and a mixture of hose clamps and factory-style clamps as well to help with the ease of installation. Speaking of which, as is tradition here at AmericanTrucks.com, we do want to show you what it takes to get the Mishimoto catch can in place. So without further ado, here's that detailed walkthrough along with a quick tool breakdown.
The tools used for this install are a ratchet, 20mm socket, 17mm socket, 15mm socket, 10mm socket, 3mm Allen, 2.5mm Allen, a flathead screwdriver, and a razor knife.
So the first step of this install is going to be to pop the hood on your truck and remove the engine cover to get access to all the PCV lines that you're going to be tapping into. So let's get started.
So to get this engine cover off, all I'm going to do is twist off my oil cap and lift up, pop the retention clips, pull the cover off, but I'll make sure to put my cap back on so nothing can get inside the engine.
All right, so there are two PCV lines on the engine, one on either side, passenger side valve cover goes from the valve cover up to the intake manifold, and then on the driver side goes from the valve cover to the inlet pipe for the turbocharger. So we're going to start with the passenger side, just lift the clip and slide this out of the way and do the same on the engine side. Get that out of there, and now we'll do the driver's side.
All right, so the driver's side PCV line actually has a sensor built into it, and we're gonna have to disconnect the connector for the sensor before we can remove the PCV line. But it's the same as the passenger side. We're just gonna unhook the clips.
Little wiggle and pull, and it comes right out.
All right, so before I can get all this going into the vehicle, what I'm gonna do is pre-install all the fittings into my catch cans on the table. They give you these aluminum barbed fittings. The large ones are a 20mm socket, the small ones are a 17mm socket, and they screw right into the catch can. and I'll just tighten up those very gently. Because these are aluminum, you don't have to go too crazy on tightening them down. They do have a rubber O-ring on them to seal. You just want to make sure they're nice and snug so they can't back themselves off. So the sensor that's in the driver's side PCV valve needs to be actually removed from the PCV hose from the factory and installed into the new PCV line provided from the kit. So what I'm going to do is use a razor blade, and I'm going to very carefully cut along the barbed fitting so that I can remove the sensor from the hoses and transfer it over to the new one. Now you do want to be very careful you don't cut down too far, because you'll damage this rubber O-ring, and this is going to help to make a good seal. So now that you have those two separated, put your hose clamp onto your new hose and slide your sensor into the hose, and then you can tighten up all your clamps. Once you have everything oriented properly, you can go ahead and use a flathead screwdriver to tighten up your hose clamps. So because some of the mounting hardware is going to be a little bit more difficult to get to with everything in the vehicle, what I'm actually going to do is pre-install the larger catch can to the bracket and the hoses to the catch can before I install it into the vehicle. But I'm not going to pre-install the smaller catch can, as it's going to interfere with the mounting bolts that mount the bracket to the firewall. So once the bracket and the larger catch can are mounted in the vehicle, then I'm going to install the smaller catch can and the hoses that go with it. So I'm going to pre-install my hose clamps onto my hoses and run them to the barbs on the catch can. Make sure that the hose that runs from your valve cover is running to the in port on the catch can, and the hose that runs to the intake manifold is running off of the out port of the catch can. Now that I have my hoses connected and my clamps tightened down, I can pre-install my bracket, and I'm just going to use the provided hardware and a 3mm Allen socket. Now we're ready to put this into the vehicle. So now I'm ready to mount the bracket and the catch can onto the firewall. I'm going to use these two studs that are over here by the master cylinder. I'm going to remove this nut with a 15mm socket, pop this clip off, and install the bracket, and reuse some of the hardware as well as some of the provided hardware from the kit. Just take my hoses and route them around the back of the engine so they stay out of my way. Slide the bracket over the studs and reuse some of the hardware. And I'll also use provided nut and washer from the kit. Slide it over the other stud.
Now just snug up the nut with the 15 millimeter socket like I used before. And a 10 millimeter socket for the nut for the kit.
So just like I did on the larger catch can, I'm going to pre-install my hoses onto the smaller catch can before I install it to the bracket in the vehicle. Once again, I'm also going to mind the orientation of the hoses themselves. The in port on the catch can itself is going to be coming from the valve cover, and the out port is going to be going to the charge pipe with the sensor connected. Now I'm ready to install this onto the vehicle.
Okay, so now I'm going to mount the smaller catch can into the vehicle using the provided hardware in the kit. And they are going to be 3 Allen head screws. You'll need a 2.5 millimeter Allen wrench to tighten these down. So now we're ready to make our connections at the PCV lines on the engine itself. And as you can see, I have everything kind of laid out here. Everything is laying where it wants to go, so that's actually pretty nice and very convenient. I'm gonna just push down on that and then lock the tab into place. And now we can just repeat these connections on the driver's side. Once again, push down over the fitting and lock the tab into place. Now for this one down here below, make sure you do not forget to plug in the sensor. Plug the sensor in and then make your connection on the PCV fitting and lock the tab into place. Now we're just gonna throw our engine cover back on and wrap this up.
And that's gonna wrap up this review and install of the Mishimoto Baffled Oil Catch Can for your 15 to 16 3.5 liter EcoBoost. Thanks for watching, and for all things F-150, keep it right here at AmericanTrucks.com.